Rename it.
So this project is about the last design prototype and production of last. This should last from the beginning, I think, see around. So it's very important to have new ways of working on last. So traditionally, you know, shulas are power made. It's traditionally in a factory with a lot of machinery, materials, processes. So in this case, it's a different approach. Starting from digital designing, digital modeling, 3D modeling. Then we use 3D printing, new technology. And if you want to make more quantity, you can use soft molds instead of going subtractive, like machining a piece of wood or plastic. You can go additive using 3D printers. So these are the three aspects: design, prototyping, and production. Okay? So. Again, this is 3D design. You have many options of footwear software, like a specific software, but you can also do it with non-specific software. In my case, I propose this way of using simple software for nerves modeling. You can use it for also designing shoe last. Then using 3D printers, you have an original or a master last. And then using soft molds, you can reproduce this to make quantity unit. Okay? This is the themes or the subjects around this way. It's everything based on digital data. So once you have the 3D model, you have then this first shape, which is the 3D object. It's 3D printed. And this is done in this way because traditionally we know that production of glass requires a lot of energy, machinery, it's a big factory, workers and everything. Time. So all these processes are, you have to mechanical risk, causing pollution, so many issues solve. If you work with just one 3D printer with your desk, it's much more easier, affordable, etc. So instead of going in a subtractive way, removing material from a block, I'm going additive. Okay, it's plus. This is not for everyone. It's basically focused on low production. So you can go if you're a bespoke and you need one pair or two pairs, maybe for one customer. Or if you work in the orthopedic industry, you don't need many glasses. And surely, if you go to a big factory, they will not produce one pair for you. So that's why you can go in this way. Also for ready-to-wear production, or even for traditional glass makers that they want to have a new research development or researching new ways of doing or making, it's also a good option. So about design, you could do the shoe last design. Obviously, this could start with the digitizing. You can digitize a foot or digitize a last. So initial data. Then you could use a specific software, CAD or computer-aided software to do this, or working with some other non-specific software. In this case, I use Rhino to do this path. Okay, so starting from foot, the same as a shoe last, there are many things that you must consider. It's a lot of measurements, parameters, but when you can rationalize this, all these measures, you can make a system, in this case it's a template, that you can use, you can edit or modify, you can handle this in geometry. It's very simple and it's based on the less control points as possible. I mean, you can handle shapes with really low quantity of information to do it more easy. The less points, the more simple. So there are some different ways of handling this geometry, because it's basic geometry, but it's always organic. You know, in a shoe last, nothing is straight, so it's, almost everything is curved or double curvature. It's complex shapes, and you can edit this with software without any problem, because digitally it's really quick, and if you have the technology, like a good interface, you can handle this in a really seamless way. Once you have this geometry, you can go 3D-dimensional. Starting from curves, you have surfaces, and these surfaces are the geometry that you can arrange it. Then you can check. Here you can check some samples. Thank you, Lucy. Thank you, Slim, for having me here. I forgot. Yesterday I was so fast and now I'm
fine.
So we have this, what you have in your hand, it's master class. In this case, it's filled with polyurethane resin. In the other case, it's filled with... it's around, yes. The gray. It's filled with wax. Okay, so you could reuse the wax, melting, and use it again, liquid, solid, as many times as you want. A new way to handle this geometry, instead of using curves, is using sub-E or sub-edition modeling. It's a bit specific. You can check this video, it's online, and it's a different way of approaching adapting a regular last into a custom last. So you can modify like sculpting, but following strictly the measures of the last of the foot. In fact, because it's made for prosthetic, so it's really accurate, but very good to use for very easy geometry and it's from Eric from the Brick, also from the Netherlands. He made AutoTools. It's a very good tool for the orthopedic industry. It's very useful in many different countries. The second part is prototyping. What you have in your hands is the first prototype. It's not made as a traditional way, but in this new way. So it's additive, it's physical. This is great because it's all impressive, but it's the same board in Mexico, here in Fagus, or China. They are doing always this by hand, carving some wood pulp with some plastic and melting and some paper. So it's a traditionally, you need many steps and prototypes are made first by hand. Then you can copy this with the traditional machine, or you can also have the newer machine. But anyhow, you have a lot of debris, waste material, and many, many processes that you can skip in this way. So this is the traditional, and this is the way I propose. This is starting from CAD. Immediately you will have this result. You can test, you can try, you can make a fitting test. If something is wrong, you go back to the computer, you fix it, and then you print it again, because this is what you have here. It's only 3 hours printing. It's hollow, it's empty inside, and then you can fill it up. if you want to hammer or if you want to put it into a machine. Right? You hammer a nail. So, once you're done, you can go to mounting. In this case, soft mold made of silicone. And then you can use casting plates to have many, as many lasts as you want. So, 3D printing is this approach, finding the right direction to print this, the right support. You're going to do it in, for example, 3 hours, and taking only 100 grams to print this through glass. So it's really affordable, basically no waste, only support you remove, so 10, 20 grams, not that much. Then I found out doing this in two parts, as you can see here. It's very good because you will use a flat base, so you don't need support. It's basically no waste. You don't have support, so it's no waste. Then you will have different thickness, and
And this system will be adopted by to make your own glass hotel, or you could become glass designer, only software and even design. If you buy the printer, you could offer the service of printing glass, or you could copy this and make low quantity, but offer to any brand or any shoemaker, maybe sport or small shoemaker, you will become a digital shoemaker. So the new ways of thinking is about how to replace plastics, because you know, I think all of these shoes were made with plastic glass. This is also plastic, so for future, I hope we can find a way to use not fossil-based materials like plastic, but some other organic material like wax or sand or ice. You can find all this document of my project, like really extensive. I cannot show you because I understand. If you want to read it, so you can find it in academia.edu. You can Google it. It's completely open. It's commercial, free. You can use it, modify it. For free. And then if you want to learn more, coming soon, you will have some training online. You can follow that training if you want to go. And thank you. That's it. Yes, please, have a question.
In order to make a prototype,
it's a good question. Yes. Yeah, the question is how to design the first program. Yes, the cut. In this case, I went, this is the version, but the first one was a straight cut, so you need 3 points of fixing. Yes. Ah, 3 parts. Yeah, no, I mean. Yes. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah, it could be 2 parts or 3 parts in this case. I think 2 is enough. And I did this step cut to avoid the rotation. And now you know only need 1. Yes. Yeah. And then you could escape. Yeah, this, here is the screw. Yes. It's just 1 screw. It used to be 3, but now it's only 1 because I did this step cut, so it's not rotating, but you need one. Yes, next slide. You're welcome. Any other questions? No, it's okay, it's a very good question. I had the same problem at the beginning. Luckily, I found the Rhinoceros, and I use it for designing everything. And I found a way to use it for mask making and shoemaking, design. So it's not a specific software, as you mentioned, it's by many specific software, only for food group, but it's not easy to handle the interface. Rhino, it's a general interface, but doing or working in this workflow is really easy to work. And I recommend to watch this video from Erin Kundering, which is live. Facebook page. This video, yeah. So then you can see how he can handle this subdivision geometry in a very simple way, starting from any shape first, and you can push and pull some control points. A really good quality last real measure for a specific shape. And then it's adapting this glass to a really customized glass. So yes, sometimes software is struggling with many complex interfaces. I know that, but that's why I try to make templates. So you can start in a regular good glass, and then you can modify it instead of starting from scratch. Or you can use some food scanner also. It's a good way as well. And the thing is that finally you will have a really good quality of geometry, and you will print directly, 3D print, and that's it. So you have many steps of handwork to have your regular as your master.
Thank you, René. We will now go to the third lecture.